I think he's going to be four this year, because I've been here for 4 years, and
yeah.
I think he was just a little baby when I came on when I first started.
That's right.
He looks a little hungry because he's trying to bite my glove, but that's okay. It's his breakfast time. She would be all rusty brown. That would be a female. And the females are much larger than the males. And that's the case with a lot of raptor species, especially falcons. The females are very, very large. So he's actually a petite little bird. You can tell he's only about 90 to 95 grams. Yet for education.
Next year.
Hopefully we'll have the Merle now. She's a beautiful bird. She actually was a rehab bird also. She had a wing fracture and was brought to our veterinarians to repair the wing, and they did, and it healed nicely, but it still wasn't releasable to the wild, so she stayed in our collection for education. So Juan and I and the rest of our staff are hoping to get her trained, and we can meet the Merlin perhaps next year.
Absolutely.
Now, would a larger raptor go after
it? Yes. Some of his primary flight feathers have fallen out, and they will come right back. Feathers are just like hair.
That's well photographed.
Yeah, okay.
Nice, thank you.
So
that's Jack.
Did you get a good shot?
Yeah, I got a great shot.
Okay. I see you have to wear those gloves.
I wear the gloves not so much for his talent, but every once in a while you can see he likes to.
I wanted to kind of like to into the whole problem because, you know, as you know, the title says urban versus prey. And, you know, by definition, birds of prey, they start to talk. Like, if you go actually, really by the definition, you go, you see, well, they talk about eagles, and hawks, and falcons, and owls, and vultures. But if you go even deep in the definition, it says, you know, animals that can actually hunt things on the wing. Meaning, like, vultures won't be on that category because they don't hunt. So it's just they rip you. It's just a big, you know, hit in the head or whatever. They don't usually try to grab, especially when they're like going so fast. They're not trying to grab anything because, you know, if you're going that fast and try to hit something to kill it and try to grab it at the same time, it's that doesn't work. So basically, they just hit it. When it feathers something in the air, they just go around.
Oh.
The bracelet. The swivel, so you know, it doesn't get tangled up, the leash. And something that is very important for whoever, you know, handled, you know, any raptor in these conditions, you have to learn to do this knot with one hand. All right, it's easy now if you do it with two hands, but do it with one hand, which, you know, you have to be sure because this is your safety. And you see, you know, you go through this motion, it's very simple, but it's still, you know, sometimes I messed up because, you know, you see, you got the actual knot in there, and then you got, you know, I put it through the loop as like an extra safety, and that's it. And you see, I just don't want her to take the wings because the wings are really, it will take a long time even to kind of break them, just even to try to eat it, because they will spend too much time. And sometimes that's the first thing that they hit, and they stay there forever, and they forget about everything else. The thing is, like, you know, if you're going 200 miles per hour and you turn your head, you're gonna go elsewhere because basically your head turned into a, you know, your directional rotor. I don't know how you call it in an airplane. Yeah, but what happened is it's easy to keep control of your dive when you actually twist around, so you don't move your head, because the head is actually definitely will make a difference. But if they twist around, they just keep. You know, keep the eye on that prey. Since they don't have the eyes in front, they have in the side. They have you know, areas where they can't see at all. So they have to kind of constantly. I mean, right now we're too many people, but if it's only me and Sierra, they will be like hitting her. They just don't care. So she's aware of they're annoying. They don't go and do anything. So she just look around. But also, yes, I mean, if it's something that she's interested,
she will bob her head, you know, especially they do that movement to kind of, that's how, like, kind of like the closing up, the zooming in. So when they're bobbing the head, they're like trying to, like, they already spot something, but they're like kind of zooming in on that specific animal.
Their hearing is not as good as their eyesight.
Wow. You're right on that.
But it's still pretty good.
They're very average. You know, they especially parents, they don't rely on hearing their prey. I mean, that's not for sure.
Okay.
Owls, besides they can see really well at night especially, they do rely on the sound.
No.
Please get full on it.
Okay.